Okay, are you ready to learn all about the transplant and donation surgical process?
Yeah, I think I'm ready to learn what it would take to go through surgery and recovery. I'm also curious about what my donor would go through.
Well, the first thing you have to know is that doctors have been doing transplant surgeries for over 50 years, and they're very good at it. However, donating a kidney and receiving a kidney transplant are also major surgeries, and like any surgery, have some risks. The transplant surgery itself takes 3 to 5 hours, but the process from waiting to begin the surgery until waking up will take 4 to 8 hours. Let's start with what happens during the surgery for the recipient, which would be you, Alfonso. During the surgery, you will be under anesthesia that will let you sleep and keep you from feeling any pain. And you will have a machine to help you breathe. While you are sleeping, the doctor will make a cut in your lower belly and place the donated kidney into your body. They will then connect the new kidney to blood vessels and your bladder. When you wake up, you will have a tube to help drain the urine from your bladder and another tube from your side that drains blood from around the new kidney. After surgery, doctors will continue to watch your blood flow to and from the kidney for bleeding and infection, and make sure your kidney isn't being rejected. Of course, like any surgery, it comes with some risks you should know about. All transplants have some risks or concerns. During surgery, the recipient might have medical problems which could stop the transplant or make the transplant surgery more complicated, such as bleeding or problems from anesthesia, which is the medicine doctors use to put you to sleep for the surgery. There is a low risk of dying from any surgery, including kidney transplant, but this risk is very low, about 3 in every 10,000 surgeries. This is why all recipients go through a lot of important medical tests to make sure it's safe for them to get surgery. After surgery, you will feel pain and will have a scar, and you may bleed. There is also a risk of kidney infection or rejection, so doctors will watch you closely.
Does the transplant always work?
Over 90% of transplants generally work for at least 1 year. Sometimes it takes time for the kidney to start working. This is called delayed graft function, and when it happens, patients need to go on dialysis for a short time while the transplanted kidney starts working. Patients doing kidney pair donation may have a higher risk for this.
Is it sort of like the kidneys needing extra time to wake up and start working?
That's a great way to think about it. In other cases, the body may reject the kidney. Doctors will treat the patient with medicine to reverse the rejection, which works 90% of the time. If you do lose the kidney, though, you will have to return to dialysis and pursue another transplant.
If the kidney works, though, then that's it?
Not exactly. You would have a new kidney then, but it's just the start. Once you've gotten your new kidney, you will need to take care of it so it can take care of you. During the first 4 weeks or so after the surgery, you will have to visit the clinic a few times every week while your body is recovering. It will take about a month before you're able to get back to normal activities fully. Then you'll be feeling better, but you will still need to visit your doctors regularly, check your kidney function and pressure regularly, and take medicines to help your kidney, prevent it from failing, and keep it from getting infected. This takes a lot of planning, so make sure you don't run out of medicine, particularly when there is a change in insurance or when you are busy or stressed. Your transplant team will help you with all of this, though. We've been talking with others and getting into so many details about the process and how everything works that I haven't gotten a chance to tell you about my own experience. I am a transplant recipient too. I got a kidney transplant from a deceased donor, although I looked into living donation as well. My sister actually offered to donate her kidney to me. I was so thankful. We went in and completed the same medical evaluation you're starting. Donors have an independent donor advocate assigned to them, whose sole focus is to protect the donor's right to choose what is right for them and their health. After my sister spoke with her independent donor advocate about the possible risks and what her recovery could look like, my sister decided not to proceed for her own personal reasons.
Why wouldn't she want to do it?
It's different for everyone. Donation is a surgery that requires time off work and time to heal afterwards. It's important and right that the potential donor feels very comfortable before they move forward. You would want that if you were thinking about being a living donor. For example, the risk of something going wrong during surgery may be more of a concern for a single parent who doesn't have anyone to help take care of their kids as they recover. Others may just feel it's the wrong time to donate due to their other responsibilities. Those were some of the reasons that made my sister change her mind.
When you put it that way, I guess I can understand it.
There are risks and concerns to donating a kidney too, just like there would be for getting a transplant.
What are some of the risks or concerns for donors?
Remember, all surgery has risks or concerns. During the surgery, the donor might have medical problems that could stop the surgery or make it more complicated, such as bleeding or problems from anesthesia. There is a low risk of dying from any surgery, but this risk is very low, about 3 in every 10,000 surgeries. This is why donors go through a lot of important medical testing as well to make sure it is safe for them to get surgery. After surgery, donors will feel pain and will have a scar, and may bleed. Donors should be able to return to their normal activities after they heal, usually between 2 to 6 weeks after donation. It is also possible that years after the donor donates, his or her remaining kidney could fail. If this happens, the donor will get priority for a kidney from the deceased donor waiting list, and in some cases, be eligible for priority for a living donor kidney transplant themselves. And some donors will have increased high blood pressure after donation. Like recipients, donors will have to visit their doctor as well, but usually only once a year to check their blood pressure and treat any other conditions early to prevent any long-term issues. There are also some emotional challenges with getting a transplant or donating a kidney. It varies how long the recipient might wait for a kidney or how long the donor may wait to donate, and the uncertainty of waiting can be difficult. There might be some stress or inconveniences from the medical evaluation as a donor or recipient. If the transplant doesn't work at all, or it doesn't work as well as expected, it can be upsetting. Also, donors and recipients will need to be okay with donating a kidney to, or receiving a kidney from, a stranger who they might never meet. Some recipients might feel badly about never knowing who their kidney donor is.
Those are all important things to think about. There are a lot of factors to consider for both of us.
I agree. I'm glad to know what I need to think through with my family before I decide. But hearing other people's stories makes it seem possible that there are ways that I might be able to help you, Alfonso.
I'm so glad that this educational process is helping you both decide what is best for you. I know this was a lot, but as your transplant and kidney pair donation coach, I wanted to be really open about all the treatment options and the possible benefits and risks to each. It's important that you talk with each other and with others who care about you. Also, share any questions you have with the transplant team, including a social worker or a psychologist, if you need to do so. You want to make the right decision for yourself.
I have one really important question I want to ask my transplant coordinator already. How do all the costs of transplant and donation get covered? Will it cost Raina anything to donate? I wouldn't want that.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
Yes, that's a very common question. Let's go ahead and take a quick break, and then I can walk you through it in detail.